According to G2 Crowd, social video generates 1,200% more shares than text and image content combined. So if you record regular podcasts for your business, you need to be able to convert that audio format into visual format for sharing online. If you do that, you're more likely to attract your target audience on social media and increase subscribers to your podcast. So with that in mind, I'm going to show you how to create unique and branded podcast artwork using Headliner and my favorite design tool. If you're new to this channel, you're very welcome. My name is Nikki Passier, and I help small businesses like you successfully market your brands online using some of the best marketing tips, tricks, and tools. So be sure to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification so that you're kept up to date with all my latest videos. Start off by typing this URL into your browser. If you already use Headliner, you can log into your account, or you can create a new account by signing up right here. Go ahead and create an account by adding a few credentials. Just follow the instructions on your screen so that you get the best experience for your projects. At the top of your toolbar, you'll see three main tabs: Create, Projects, and Automations, which is still in beta. I'm going to stick with the Create tab. And you can see I have five options to make an audiogram. I'll leave you to explore in your own time which each one does, but I want to get straight into the tutorial today, so I'm going to click on Audiogram Wizard. Next, you'll be prompted to upload your audio file. The maximum is 2 hours, and you can upload MP3, WAV, or M4A files. Even though I have 13 minutes of audio file, I only need a 1 minute snippet for sharing on social media. If you need any more audio, just hover your mouse over the end bar and drag it to wherever you want it to end, or type in the exact duration in this box here. I'm just going to stick with the 1 minute snippet, so I'm going to click on Instagram 1 minute. Next, I'm going to select Add Captions to Video. And these are automated captions, so I'm just going to toggle this button to the on position. I'm going to select my transcription language. So I'm going to scroll down until I find English, United Kingdom. Once I'm done, I'm going to click on Next. On this screen, you'll be prompted to select a template from Landscape, which is best for YouTube and websites, a square template, which is best for Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, or you can choose a portrait template, which is perfect for Instagram stories, Snapchat, and TikTok. So I'm going to stick with the square template and click on Next. You might want to get into the good habit of naming your project straight away in case you run into difficulties. And then click on the blue Create button. With a free account, you get 5 unwatermarked videos. But if you want unlimited watermarked videos, you need to upgrade to a pro account. Now, to edit your audio track, just click on the blue Open Advanced Editor. This may take a couple of minutes, depending on the length of your audio, so you might want to go away and get yourself a cup of coffee or a cup of tea. If you're using Headliner for the first time, you'll be given some really handy guides. So, for instance, if you want to add your own text, you can click on the text track. You can add some media, such as an image, a video, or a GIF file. And you can even add a really eye-catching waveform. Your audio transcript will appear on the left-hand side of your screen. Begin by checking your captions for spelling, to check the grammar and add any capital letters and punctuation. To edit the captions, you'll want to place your cursor inside the caption boxes, click once until the box turns white, and then make your alterations. Scroll through the captions just to make sure that they're absolutely correct. When you're done, you want to add your captions to a text track. So you need to click on this little tiny icon here, copy captions, and here are your captions on the text track. Once that's done, click on the play button here to make sure that the captions match the audio. If the timings are slightly out, you can adjust them in two ways. You can place your cursor inside these little boxes here and adjust the timing, Alternatively, hover your mouse over the end bars, hold your cursor down, and move them to the correct position. You can customise the text by clicking on the text track once. You can customise the font, change the size of the font, change the font colour, the alignment. You can also select a general style, so I'm going to select the default style, and add any transitions. If you want to add a waveform to your graphic, just click on the blue circle with the white cross in it. Next, you'll be prompted to choose whatever wave style you want by clicking on the downward arrow and making your selection, so you have lots to choose from here. You can customize the color. You can position your waveform. When you're done customizing the waveform, just click Add to Video. And now comes the fun part. Go to the top left-hand corner of your toolbar and you'll notice there's a tab that says Media. So you want to click on Media and then click on the Add Media button. You can use the Search tab to do a search for some general images, videos, or GIF files. If you search for images, you can use a keyword to narrow down your search, such as podcast, and then click on Search, and then select whichever image you prefer. In the same way, you can search on videos for, say, a desktop, click on Search, and you can see some stock videos right underneath. If you don't want to use stock images and videos, you can also click on the Upload tab to upload your own images. Simply drag and drop them into place, upload them from your local device, or copy and paste a video or image URL into the box provided. I don't want to do any of that, so I'm going to move along and click on the Create button. And this is where things get very exciting for me, because you can create an image directly from within Headliner using CANVA. To do this, you want to click on the Create an Image button, and Headliner will magically take you right across to CANVA without even having to leave the Headliner app. Now you have various options. You can select a pre-formatted template from the Templates tab, scroll down and choose whichever takes your fancy. You can start from scratch using a blank template, or if you've been very clever and you've already created an image in CANVA and you want to import it into Headliner, all you need to do is find it from your graphics and click on your graphic to pop it into your template. Once that's done, all you need to do is click on the white Publish button to transfer it directly into your Headliner template. And there it is. When you're happy with your image, just click Add to Video. And you can see now your podcast graphic is really starting to take shape. Before publishing your graphic, just click on the Play button to make absolutely sure you don't need to make any final edits and adjustments. And I've just noticed that my captions completely overlap the waveform, so I'm going to go back into the waveform, click on it once to edit it, and I'm going to manually move the waveform up onto the top of my graphic and click on Save. And that looks so much better. I think that's perfect and it's ready to publish. So I'm going to go to the right hand side of my screen and click on Export. Make sure you leave an email address if you want to get an email notification when your video is ready. Otherwise, click the blue Export My Video button right at the bottom. Now all that's left to do is publish your beautiful graphic onto social media, or click on the Download button to download it to your local device. And this is what the final graphic looks like. And that is all there is to it. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please do give it a thumbs up to support my channel. You don't need a paid CANVA account to be able to create podcast artwork, but if you'd like to benefit from my exclusive 45-day free upgrade to CANVA Pro, you will find the link in the description box below. I have a whole playlist of CANVA tips and tricks, so be sure to check them out coming up on the end screen right now. I will see you in the next tutorial. Bye for now.